Here I am going to explain you about the concept of fiber reinforced concrete. Before starting with the FRC, let us start from the basic material, that is concrete section. So all of us know that the concrete is very, very much strong in compression, and also the one more important character of the concrete, it is its brittle nature when it comes to its failure pattern. Okay. In the initial stages, lots of tests were conducted on the concrete section, and it has proved that it can bear the higher compressive strength, but at the same time it cannot bear any type of the flexural stresses or the tensional stresses. It cannot bear. So whenever you applied a load on the concrete section, especially in its tension zone, there will be a formation of the cracks, and if you continue to load further, the crack will propagate till its top fiber, and the concrete section will undergo failure. Okay, so in order to avoid such failure pattern or the sudden failure pattern of the concrete section, or to improve the properties of the ductility, that is to improve the ductile property of the concrete, a steel material was introduced into the concrete section, where it is nothing but a steel. It is a very much strong material which can resist any amount of the tensile stresses. Thereby, the weak property of the concrete section was increased with the provision of the steel member. Okay, so this concept was refers to the reinforced concrete section. Here you can see the example. I have written a cross section where I have drawn even the concrete as well as the steel members I have drawn here. So this is your steel member, and this is the longitudinal section, RC beam, longitudinal section it is. So the weakest property, that is weak characteristics of the concrete, that is brittle nature or the weak intention, was improved by providing the steel bars in its tension zones as well as the compression zone. Okay, then what is this concept of the FRC? Anyhow, we have increased its ductile carrying capacity or the ductility strength we have increased, but still even the reinforced concrete also falls short of many desirable properties such as toughness, energy absorption, crack control and the ductility. So in order to improve all these mechanical properties, it is very much necessary to distribute the reinforcement uniformly throughout the cross section. Here in the case of RC, what happens? The reinforcement has been provided only in the certain pockets of the cross section. Only it is provided in the top surface, bottom surface, that is rub zone, compression zone and the tension zone, and the reinforcement is provided in the form of the stirrups for the shear, as a shear reinforcement. But still it has become insufficient to resist the other various stresses acting over it. So in order to improve the other various mechanical properties, it is very much necessary to distribute this reinforcement uniformly throughout the cross section. Okay, so then the concept of the fibers were introduced. Okay, so this is the concept of the fiber reinforced concrete, where a short fibers of small diameter, the fibers can be anything, metallic fibers, non-metallic fibers, glass fibers, any agro waste, we can any bamboo fibers or any natural fibers, coir fibers, any fibers can be used here. Okay, so in order to improve its various mechanical properties, the fibers which are very much short and having a smallest diameter, it was distributed uniformly throughout the cross section. I have written the sketch here. See, whatever it is I am showing here, all these are all shorter fibers. So this shorter fibers, if you just distribute it throughout its cross section properly, you can achieve the desirable mechanical properties such as toughness and the control of cracking you can achieve. That thereby the concept of the FRC was introduced.